Yes. Hi guys, hey, Rachna Ranade here, and I welcome you all to the 7 PM live stream. Today's stream is special for two reasons. Number one, we are having a discussion on a topic which got carried forward from yesterday. Many viewers were saying that, ma'am, please continue, please tell us about PEG. But then I thought that yesterday there was too much of confusion, so I will carry this forward to today. So today we are going to do PEG, which is a much awaited topic, number one. Number two, this is a record for me that I'm doing the third live stream in one day on YouTube. I did a live stream at 12 noon wherein I conducted a very small quiz, and that was on behalf of YouTube. We did some fun activities like Bollywood, cricket, and some stock market quiz questions. So yeah, it was all in all, it was great fun. In the live stream of 12 noon, I had told that whenever I will come for the 7 p.m. live stream, I will be announcing the winners. Okay, so today's live stream is going to be something like this. First, I'm going to teach PEG. Okay, second, we are going to take the normal questions which you all have, and towards the end of this live stream, what we are going to do is we are going to announce the winners for the 12 noon live stream. Okay, before we start with what is PEG, let's do this activity. Share this live stream on your YouTube or on your WhatsApp or Facebook or Insta, and let me know who has done it. You can paste that quickly so that PEG can be learned in a very effective way by your friends who are interested in finance. I'm waiting so that, okay, Chetan done, very good. Aproop has already done it. Satvikil says first live stream, cool. Chetan says first, okay, done. Chaitanya says done, Ruthvik says done, Manal says yes, go, go, go. Pushkar says done, very good. Many people have done it, at least I can see done and invited one of my friend, Mansoor, very good. perfect, done. Akash says 12 was your first live stream, okay, perfect. First live, there are so many people, first time, okay. There are so many first timers in the evening stream today, good to see that. Maybe it's all because of those who are attending the 7 p.m. daily. And I think rather than my credit, I feel it's your credit that you have invited your friends, and that is why your friends are joining in for the very first time. So good. Harsh Reddy says, I have shared with my friend in Germany. He has purchased your FA lecture series. Thank you, Harsh. Perfect. Many people first time on the live stream, feels good. Before we move on with the PEG ratio, I think just a quick welcome to all the new members. Sham, Sagar, Rohan, KP Sekon, Mandar, Rohan, Anant, Ashutosh, Vishwajit, Jha, and I guess one more is Nikhil Srivastav. Okay, perfect. So a big welcome to you all. So shall we start with the PEG ratio? Okay, there are many new members today, so feels happy. Let's start with PEG ratio. Everyone has to focus today. We are going to take with very basics. First of all, I'll give you a quick introduction about PEG, and then we'll move on to how to calculate PEG, how to see PEG, is it readily available or not, what could be the different approaches for PEG, everything we are going to do in detail one by one. Okay, so very first thing, what is PEG? Numerator is what? PE. And what is the denominator? Growth. Okay. So what is PE? PE is what? Price to earnings ratio. Okay. So I'll give you a very simple example. Because yesterday I got the suggestion that whenever you're explaining something, please show it on the laptop so that it becomes easy to visualize. Okay. So I'm going to quickly show you on laptop about PEG ratio. Okay, so how is the PG ratio calculated? PE upon G. G is what? Growth. Okay. Now, what is PE? PE is nothing but what? PE is price upon earnings per share. Of course, the price which I'm talking about is also price per share upon earnings per share. Now, what is EPS is what we have discussed yesterday very much in detail. but for those who are not there yesterday, number one. Or number two, just to give you a very quick revision, like in 30 seconds or maximum 1 minute, I'll tell you in very simple words, crisp words, one quick revision about EPS. Okay, so focus 100%. Let us say I have a company and my total earnings, is it sales or total earnings is profit? Total earning, final earning, net earnings is nothing but my profit after tax. Okay, final earnings after all the expenses is rupees, let us say 10,000. Okay, this is my profit after tax. Assume that I am the sole shareholder of the company. Okay, I started the company, I earned a profit after tax of 10,000. Who owns this 10,000? Who is 10,000 ka hakdar kaun hai? Who is eligible to enjoy this 10,000? Me and only me, because I am the only shareholder of this company. Okay, but assume that I am not the only shareholder of the company, and now assume that there are total 100 shareholders of the company. Okay, and everyone has only one share. Okay, so one more time, there are total 100 shareholders of the company and every shareholder has one share. So total how many shares? 100. Now this 10,000 can be enjoyed by only me, or this 10,000 will be enjoyed by all 100 people put together? Everyone quick answer. This 10,000 will be enjoyed by whom? Enjoyed by all 100 people. Very good. Okay, you're getting this answer. 10,000 will be enjoyed by all 100 people. So if I ask you, one person enjoys how much profit? One person enjoys how much profit? So for that, we are calculating this. Earnings per share will be equal to 100. Okay. So very good. Everyone is giving me a correct answer today. So this is the most simplified form for earnings per share. Behind every share, how much earnings can I enjoy? Okay. Now the next question comes up. Please understand. Now for this stock, let us say I'm talking about some company A. Okay, or Rachna Ranade Limited. Okay, so for this stock, assume that the earning per share is how much? Right now we had calculated earning per share is 100. And assume that my company is listed on the stock exchange. Okay, and the price of my share, current market price of my share is 200 rupees. Current market price of my share is 200 rupees. Okay, my question to you is, how much will be the PE ratio? How much will be the PE ratio? Very good. Anish, Vivek, Chinmay, Aparup, Akash. Dhanush Kodi, I wrote it in a different way. See, price is 200 and EPS is 100. So it's 200 divided by 100. It is 2:1. Okay, so EPS is how much? Sorry, PE ratio is how much? PE ratio is 2. Absolutely okay till here? No doubt. Very good. Everyone is giving me a correct answer. I'm assuming that everyone has understood this. PE ratio is 2. Now, very, very, very important is how to interpret this PE ratio. PE ratio of 2 means what? Okay. Now, please understand this very carefully. PE ratio is nothing but how much times I'm ready to pay as a price to acquire that share. So, one more time, to acquire the share of that company, how much times of the earnings I'm ready to pay. Okay, one more time. This is a little bit tricky. How much times of the earnings I am ready to pay to get one share of the company? Okay, so let us understand this. I am ready. If P ratio is 2, it means that I am ready to pay twice of the current earnings. Okay, how much is current earnings? Current earning is 100 per share. So I know that if I buy one share, understand this. If I buy one share, I know that I am entitled to how much rupees? If I own one share, how much amount am I entitled to? I want answers. Vishwajit gives me the correct answer. If I own one share, I'm entitled to 100 rupees. Very good. Even if I'm entitled to 100 rupees, I'm ready to pay how much? Even if I'm entitled to 100 rupees, I'm ready to pay how much? Very good. I'm ready to pay 200. And that, yes, very good. I'm ready to pay 200. I hope you are getting this. Last time I'm telling this, even if I'm earning 100, I'm ready to pay 200. That means I'm ready to pay twice the earnings of the company. Is it absolutely okay till here? That is nothing but PE ratio. Now the question comes up is, if I am ready to pay twice of its earning, is it expensive? If I'm comparing the existing earning of the company, which is 100, I'm ready to pay twice of the earnings. Question is this expensive or not? I can't get an answer whether it is expensive or not with only PE ratio. Okay, I can't get this with only PE ratio. So let us understand, PE ratio, I can compare with something else so that I can understand whether this 2 is expensive or not. Okay, there is no mathematical formula which says that if PE ratio, just as an example, okay, if PE ratio is up to 5, then okay. If PE ratio is up to 6, okay, there's no formula for that. Okay, so in simple words, I have to compare PE ratio with something so that I get some good comparison of whether the stock is cheap or whether the stock is expensive. Is this okay? What could be the possibilities? I'm already getting good answers. Vijay Bhaskar says that there are 2 possibilities. I compare this company's PE ratio with its peers. Okay, possibility number 1, I compare this company's PE ratio with its peers. Possibility number 2, I compare this company's PE ratio with the industry average. Okay, 2 everyone knows. Okay, so possibility number 1, comparing with peers. Possibility number 2, comparing with industry average. Possibility number 3 is what we are going to discuss today. Okay, and what is that possibility? I compare the PE ratio of the company with its own growth. With its own growth, and that is nothing but the denominator here. I compare PE with its growth. I hope you're understanding till here. And that is nothing but PEG. I'm comparing PE with G. Is this okay? Right? Yes, people are saying yes, yes, yes. Okay, so yes, you can compare price with book value, you can compare price with anything else, agreed. But right now, I'm comparing the PE with growth. Fantastic. Wow. People are getting this wow component. Thank you, Sinu, Pushkar. Thanks for the immediate feedback. So we are comparing PE with growth. Question is what? What is growth? Okay. Growth of what? Growth of sales? No. It's growth of profit. Okay. We are now going to compare profit growth. Year on year profit growth. So now let's understand this. If profit growth, okay, see this, if I'll just clean this up so that you understand this in a better way, or check this out. Okay, so how much was our PE ratio? PE ratio was 2. Okay, question is, how much was the PAT growth? Okay, some websites take it as EPS growth also. So it's okay, it's almost going to give you the same answer. I'm repeating, it could be the EPS growth or it could be the PAT growth. Okay, profit after tax growth. So how much was the PAT growth? Okay, assume that profit after tax growth was, let us say, 1. Okay, not in 1 rupee terms as such, but 1%. Okay, profit grew by 1%. But the P ratio is 2%. What does that mean? For a growth of only 1% year on year, I am ready to pay twice the price. So growth, now if I draw here, growth is only 1%. Okay, this is 1. This is 2. Growth is only 1%. But I am paying twice the earnings. See, PEE is earnings. This PAT growth, if I say EPS, because I said it's same. See, finally, here it is also earnings. Here is also it is earnings. So for 1% of earning, I am paying what? Twice. Is this expensive? Very good. Now people are getting this. People are saying it is expensive. Fantastic. Okay. Let's take case 2. Case 2 is what? The growth of the company, here let us take it is 3, here let us take it is 4. The growth, year on year growth, its EPS, earnings per share, case number 2, grew by 4%. Okay, its EPS grew by 4%. But its P ratio is 2. We are paying only twice the current earning. We are paying twice of the current earning. But the growth is expected at 4%. So compare 2 with 4 now. Is it better now? Yes. No. Growth is 1% I'm talking about. Okay. Is it now much better? As compared to case 1. Okay. As compared to case 1. Case 2 is better. Okay. I hope you are getting this. So see, please understand. In PEG, We don't compare percentage as such. We are comparing the absolute numbers for PEG. Okay, so we compare two is so we are comparing two PE with EPS of one. Okay, so it's a figure on figure comparison. I'm again repeating it. PE is not percentage, I know that, but in PEG ratio, percentages are not compared, the absolute values are compared. I'm repeating this. In PEG ratio, I have not come up with the PEG ratio, it's not my invention. Okay, PEG ratio says that you have to compare the absolute values. So growth percentage, whatever is the growth percentage, we have to compare it with the PE ratio. That is how you will get it. Is this okay? Growth factor means what? I'm going to take more numericals on this. Prima facie, I hope this is clear. Prima facie. Okay, what I've done is I've also taken a numerical here. Let's understand this. I hope this is visible. Okay, so that you can understand it in a much better way, let's check this out. Company A, okay. There was one question who asked that how to calculate growth. How to calculate growth is what I'm explaining right now. Okay. EPS of this year, earning per share of this year is 2.09%. Earning per share of the previous year was 1.74%. Okay. Question is how to calculate the growth. Okay. This is taught in school. How to calculate growth? It's a percentage growth. One possibility is 2.09 minus 1.74 divided by 1.74 into 100. As a percentage, okay. So possibility number one, what we were taught in school is 2.09 minus 1.74 divided by 1.74 into 100. Possibility number one as a percentage. Or simple one can be 2.09 divided by 1.74 minus 1. This is an alternative way, okay. This is normal mathematics, okay. Nothing related to stock market. So if you calculate this, here you can see earnings growth is what? 2.09 was the current year's EPS, 1.74 was the previous year's EPS minus 1. So what is the growth here? Growth is 20%. So EPS grew by 20%. Okay, till here? EPS grew by how much? 20%. If my EPS is growing by 20%, now question is, so we'll talk about PEG now. Wait, let's talk about the PE ratio now. Okay, so assume that here we are assuming that this is the market price. Per share. This is an assumption, okay? We are assuming that market price so that we could get some round figures. I've assumed this. Price per share is 46 rupees, okay? Divided by what? Earnings per share. How much was earning per share? 2.09. This year's was 2.09. Is this okay? So PE ratio was calculated by 46 divided by 2.09. That is what? 22. Okay? Right, 22 is PE. Very good. Simple calculation, ekdam simple calculation. Earnings growth we just now calculated at 20%. So what is PEG ratio? Again, I am repeating, we are not supposed to take percentages. We are required to take absolute figures whenever I calculate PEG. The person who came up with this formula, who has invented this formula, he has told this that we have to calculate, we have to take absolute figures here. So 22 by 20 is what? 1.1. Okay. So now what does this mean? Let us understand. This means that we are paying 22 times more for a growth rate of what? 20. Okay. So are we paying a little bit more? Are we paying a little bit more? Yes or no? Okay, scroll up please. Theek hai? Yes, we are paying a little bit more. Agreed. So instead of this, let us take this. Had my PE been 22, okay, had my PE been 22 and my growth would have been 44, 44% growth. I'm having a 44% growth. Then my ratio would have been how much? Again, first standard mathematics, my ratio would have been, PEG would have been 0.5. Very good. Is this now cheaper? Very good. This is cheaper. This is cheaper. Yes. Fantastic. Now it becomes cheap. in simple words, now understand, in simple words, can I sum up this entire discussion by stating that if the PEG is equal to or less than 1, if PEG is equal to or less than 1, then it is cheap. But if the company's share price is cheap, but if it is greater than 1, then it is expensive. One more time, if PE ratio, if PEG is less than or equal to 1, then it is cheap, and if it is greater than 1, then it is expensive. Yes, 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 many people are saying yes. Perfect. Yes, yes, getting many answers as yes, yes. Mansoor loves Tathastu. Sure, PEG less than or equal to 1 is cheap. Perfect. Yo. Super ma'am, understood now. Nice, nice, nice. Very good, very good. Now, let's understand one more thing. Are you ready for one advanced step? So, just to sum up one more time very, very, very quickly. In simple words, PEG less than or equal to 1, I may say company is undervalued. Tushar asks, so ideal PEG ratio is either 1 or below 1. Tushar, you are correct. So this is a go ahead. Okay, one of this, oh, wait. This is only one of the parameters. Huh? Can you just blindly buy a company? Oh, PEG is less than 1, buy. Don't do that. Otherwise, you might be at risk. Don't do that. This is just one of the valuation models. Okay, good, perfect. And can I say PEG is greater than 1 is overvalued? And I should stay away from such a company. Mayank Sharma, that's what I told you right now. If this is less than or equal to 1, then it can be a good buy. It's undervalued. Okay. I hope this is clear. Are you ready for one advanced step? Are you ready for one advanced step? If yes, let me know so that I can just go one step ahead. Yes, yes, yo, ma'am. Okay, perfect. Now think carefully and answer this. Okay. We are saying that if company is growing at a very good pace, okay, if company is growing at a very good pace, then I'm happy. Okay. If company is growing at a very good pace, I'm ready to pay more. If company is not growing at a very good pace, I'm not ready to pay that much more. So a company who has a very good growth rate, a company which has a very high EPS, I'm ready to pay more for that stock. Okay. Yes. If the growth rate is very nice, I'm ready to pay more. But if the growth rate is not that good, I'm not ready to pay more. Okay. Question is, now here comes a tricky question. As an investor, would I be more interested to check the previous growths or would I be interested to know about the future growth? So I'm saying that I'm ready to pay twice the amount. I'm ready to pay twice the earnings. But for that, should I be checking previous growths, 10 years ago growth, 5 years ago growth, or I would be interested in future growth? Okay, both, future growth, perfect. Okay, but what is the tricky part? I understand that both can be seen, agreed. So one is called as the forward PEG or one is called as the trailing PEG. Okay, what is trailing PEG? Trailing PEG means till now, what has happened? Okay, what is the word trailing? Trailing PEG is what has happened till now. And forward PEG means what we are expecting in the future. Okay, but this is the biggest question as to how will I know what is the expected PEG? And if expected PEG is less than 1, then maza aa gaya. Right? So, I exactly, Pratish is saying it correctly. To calculate what will be the growth in a particular company. See, we are not that high level investors. Na? We don't get access to the management directly. We can't ask the management, what is your expected growth? Which big fund houses do get an access to the management? They can ask the management directly. How much is the expected growth? We don't have any specific source for that. So there could be two possibilities. Possibility number one can be you can check, you can calculate very easily PEG ratio using the previous data, or possibility number two, you can calculate this using the forward data. Okay. But then question is, do we have ready-made data? If yes, please share, where can we get ready-made data? Phukat ka data chahiye kya? Free wala data. Do you want that? Say yes, then I will share it with you. Do you want free data? How to calculate trailing PEG based on previous data? How to calculate by readily available PEG and future PEG? Yes. Better calculate, why not? But if it is freely available, easily available, why not as well? Okay, so here I have given the website link. We have been using this link for so many days. Okay, screener.in. Is this visible? Maybe it is not. Wait, 1 minute. Is it visible now? Maybe yes. Phukat te paushtik, agdi barobar hai. Okay, so let us say I am talking about Larsen and Toubro. Right. Okay, I just added this up. You just have to check here. 1 minute. I'll show you how to add the ratio as well. I've already talked about how to add ratios. But still you can see here. Anyways, I had already added PEG ratio. Otherwise, what you can do is, you can just type PEG here. Is the screen visible? Because I'm not able to see it on my mobile chat. Maybe I'll just try one more time by refreshing it. Yes, but it is stuck. Exactly, I thought so. 1 minute, 1 minute. Okay, so again I'm trying this Larsen and Toubro. It's not working. Maybe it will now. Wait. I guess it is working now. Just check. Just give me a thumbs up if it is working or not. Now, okay. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. So, what I did is I just opened screener.in. Okay. And now, what are we doing here? We just have to add a ratio. What is the ratio that we are wanting to add? PEG. Just type out PEG. Okay. We type out PEG. It's asking for a username password. Man. Okay. You can check that. Okay, wait. I'll do one thing. See the word screen till then. I will log in quickly. The word screen is visible, na? Okay. Just give me 1 minute, okay? I'm logging in. All right, I'm almost done. Perfect. Now let me know if the screen is visible, and I've logged in. It's visible now. Okay, perfect. I'll scroll up, don't worry. Okay, so what is the PEG ratio for Larsen? It is 0.86. PEG ratio is how much? Can you see here? PEG ratio is 0.86. It's very simple. If you don't have it on your screen, what you just have to do is add ratio, and you have to type here PEG. It should come up. You just have to tap PEG ratio and it will start appearing here. I hope this is clear. PEG 0.86. I want quick answer. With 0.86 PEG, prima facie LNT with this valuation parameter is overvalued or undervalued? This is one of the valuation method, guys, not the only valuation method. Is this trailing? Yes, Pratish, this is trailing. Perfect. Undervalued with this one. This is less. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Undervalued, undervalued. Very good. Okay, so so simple. I can just check out any company. So, for example, your favorite idea. Oh, sorry. We'll take a party fund stock, na? For that, PEG is, searching PEG is also useless actually. Because that earnings for them is going to be like in minus. So PEG ratio is going to be crazy for them. See, PEG ratio is nothing. Because it's in minus. Okay. Okay. Someone wants to see Trent. Okay. Trent. Okay. Good. So here you can see Trent is how much? 2.28. I want an answer again quickly. Overvalued or undervalued? Overvalued or undervalued? Yes, with this ratio it is overvalued. Absolutely. Okay, why? Because the PEG ratio is more than one. Okay, I hope I have given ample examples. Now, if you want to check out what is its forward PE. Forward PE is also very important. And can you believe we get forward PE readily available on in.finance.yahoo.com. Okay, so we will check this out. It's opening on which screen? 1 minute. I'll just copy paste this link. Copy and paste. Right here. Okay, so here I can check out. So someone said Trent. Trent Limited. All right. So Trent Limited, we are going into statistics. Statistics, they say PEG 5-year expected. They have said not applicable. I'm wondering why they have not given here. Not sure why they have not given here. Any other, like, I was, because of the Bank of China thing, I was just checking. Okay, wait, not HDFC Bank. I was searching HDFC today, the main company. Oh, we'll also check L&T. Why not? Sure. See, this is 5-year expected. 5 years expected growth is 1.81. Okay, so this is an expected PE that we are talking about, PEG that we are talking about. This is trailing. If you can see, there is a small one written here. Okay, now what is this one? It gives us a footnote, data provided by Thomson Reuters. And this is like one of the famous data collection organizations. You might have seen that Reuters or Reuters. The pronunciation is a bit tricky. Reuters maybe. Okay, so the data is collected by them. Based on that, they calculate the forward PE. Let's check Larsen & Toubro. Ooh, today it's up 6.5%. And I told this, it's a good one. Okay, PEG. Oh, now see this. The expected PEG, 5-year PEG will be 1.52. So, in now who can tell me the interpretation for this? 1.52. 5-year expected is 1.52. But, so this is a tricky one. I'll quickly tell you. What was the interpretation for the trailing PEG? Tell me. For L&T trailing PEG. I'll show it here also now. Larsen. Yes, Sinu says it. Maybe down the line it grows. Price in 5 years will be comparatively expensive. Cheaper to buy today, but prices might go up in the future. Absolutely, you're getting it. Perfect. So if you see here, current PG or the trailing PG is 0.86, but the upcoming PG for the 5 years expected will be 1.52, correct? So can be a good buy based on this single valuation parameter, can be a good buy right now. It may become expensive if you're talking about a 5 years time horizon. Okay? Have you understood this? We did a big discussion on PEG today. I hope you have understood this very nicely. I don't think I could have done this. Easier than this was impossible, I guess. Totally understood. Yes. Very good. Every day PE changes due to daily price change. So how can we calculate current PE as EPS was previous quarter not? So daily it changes. Agreed. PE ratio changes daily. So instead of, if you don't want a daily PE, then you can download the data. You can have an average PE for the past 3 months or so that the PE is evened out. We can have a separate live stream for that because PE changes every day. So we can have an av we can take we can download the 3 months data, 3 months price data. We can average it out and we can then calculate what is the average PE. We can do a separate session on that. Trailing PE is like, so like TTM is a terminology which is used on many websites. TTM is trailing 12 months. Last 12 months is trailing. Immediate previous is trailing. Okay. Samida says, what a wow concept. Thank you, Samida. Oh, sorry. The concept was wow. It's not about the explanation. Okay. Right. Yes, Vivek says, idea gave good return today. Thanks, ma'am, for suggesting it as a party fund. My pleasure. Harish says, ma'am, never thought lockdown would be such a blessing for me. Thank you, Harish. Any other quick questions? Ha, Tinmay says teacher is all. Thank you. Someone is asking, maybe can there be a scenario analysis? Yes, scenario analysis is doable. Lai bari, dhanyawad. Okay, so maybe just one or two quick questions, else we can move on with the next set which I had planned for the day, which was calculating, I mean, announcing the winners for the morning live stream. SBI card down. I guess I told this in one of my previous streams that the spending will definitely decrease in the coming months as well. So that is the reason why companies like SBI cards are going to have a tough time in the coming future. Trailing PE and PE is same. If it so if it trailing or if it is TTM, I'll be a bit specific. TTM is trailing 12 months. So, for example, right now, if I'm talking about trailing 12 months, like December 2019 will be the latest data available, right? So, TTM for December 19 would be Jan 19 to December 19. Okay, but normal EPS will be April to March. I hope this is understood. April to March is a normal EPS, but TTM EPS will be last available data ke hisab se, as per the last available data. Okay. Sputnik, thanks for the super chat. How to get relative strength ranking of stocks? Relative strength ranking of stocks. So for that, you can't depend on a single valuation parameter. Like we discussed PEG today, we have to check PE, we have to check PEG, and so many more, and then you can come up to a conclusion. Okay. Chaitra, thank you for the super chat. Hello ma'am, need your advice. I have sold one lot of gold mini at 42K. You have sold. Oh my God. And it's in huge loss. Can I sell one more lot to average or exit? Chaitra, depends on your view. Because if you have short on gold, then you feel that gold should ideally go down. Okay. That means that stock market should go up. See, this is the thumb rule. Okay. 90 out of 100 times I can say that it happens that stock market and gold go in exact different directions. Okay, so if you feel that market is going to go up and gold will go down, then you can short one more. But if you feel that market has already gone up a lot, there is a time for correction, then shorting one more will be risky. Okay, but again, you can do your own analysis as well. Okay, I guess with that, someone is asking, ma'am, growth rate 1 year, 3 year, 5 year. That depends how much you have to take. You can take 3 years. So if you're talking about trailing again, you can take 3 years growth, compare it with what is the current growth rate. So for example, let us say my current growth rate is very close to the 3 year growth rate. Then you can go ahead with the 3 year growth rate. If my current growth rate is closer to the 5 year growth rate, so compare na, current year trend is following which trend, or current year growth rate is pretty close to the overall 10 year growth rate, then you can go ahead with 10 year growth rate also. All these are available on screener.in. How to invest in debentures through Zerodha? I'm not sure about this, whether Zerodha platform allows investment in debentures or not. I'll have to check on that though. But if they are like listed debentures, then ideally you should be able to invest. That should not be a problem. Listed debentures should be, you should be able to invest in that. Vivek Kaushik asks, how will the market be for next 15 days? That's a tough question to answer. Market today, if you have seen, I can show 1 minute. Let me just in dot trading view. Wait, in dot trading view. And if I see Nifty, Nifty did not close above the round figure mark. Okay, again, one more thing. This is my interpretation. This is my analysis. I may be right, I may be wrong. Okay, but today market did not close above the psychological mark of 9,000. Okay, I feel psychology also plays a big role in market sometimes. So it did not close above that 9,000 ka psychological mark. Had it closed above that 9,000 ka psychological mark, I feel that it would have run up a little bit in the coming few days. Okay, I'm repeating one more time. This is my interpretation, that because market did not close above the 9,000 ka psychological support, I feel that markets are expected to correct in the coming few sessions. Tomorrow, anyways, it's a holiday if I'm not mistaken. Tomorrow is Baba Sahib Ambedkar Jayanti. So tomorrow anyways markets are closed. But I feel that we have seen a big run up in the past few sessions. I think markets might correct a little bit in the coming few sessions. My interpretation. Okay, Aproop, thank you for the super chat. Ma'am, please teach us calculating intrinsic value. It's a big discussion. We are working on that as to how can intrinsic value be calculated. We are trying to build up some Excel sheets for that as well. My team is working on that. We are trying to build up something very easier format for you. Once it is done, I will let you know in the live streams. Okay. Okay, Shreya, thank you for the super chat. Can we create a parameter list which will help us to take the decision of buy or not to buy? Absolutely, Shreya. Shreya, what you can do is like in screener.in, you can set up your own parameters, na? And if the stock, whatever stock you are thinking about, if it is satisfying all the parameters, then you can definitely go ahead with that. You can create a list of that. Rajesh, start Rachana tips for the week, next party fund. If I do that, then I feel that I'll be going more as a person who gives tips rather than a person who teaches how to find out stocks. And I can see, Rajesh, I hope you understand this, that I can easily do this. I can say that I will give you some chargeable tips. And even if I give it at a throwaway price, I think there'll be so many people who will be subscribing for that. But I'm not that type of a person who would just give tips and you invest based on my tips. I don't want that. I would rather prefer you prefer teaching you the concept, you doing your analysis and investing rather than me giving tips. So, yeah. Still, I gave idea as a party fund thing. Yes Bank as a party fund thing. Okay. Okay. About Sonata Software. It's a company which has a very good growth rate. I can show that quickly on screener as well. We can check based on today's valuation ratio also. I guess Sonata has a very good growth. Okay, Sonata is a global technology company that enables successful platform based on digital transformation. Okay, fair enough. See, year on year sales growth is 46.56%. Profit growth for 5 years is 26.8%. Okay, 17%. Okay, debt to equity is very good. Industry PE is 9. And their PE is 6. Okay, good. And PEG, see guys, PEG is only how much? 0.25. With a very quick research, all in all, looks to be a good company, but this is with only very selective features. Okay, there's only one problem here. Free cash flows are in negative. I wouldn't want this unless and until they have they're buying more and more of equipments, that is where they have invested. Otherwise seems good one. Thank you for the super chat, Pooja ma'am. Waiting for detailed sessions on F&O. Yeah, you will get it slowly and steadily. We are working on so many things currently. So yeah, Sangam says doesn't generate cash. Sangam, that's not a very correct interpretation. Rather than saying that doesn't generate enough cash, I may say that possibility number one, they are genuinely not generating enough from operations, or possibility number two, they are investing this money to enhance their fixed assets further. Okay. Dhananjay, thank you for the super chat. Okay, I guess with that, we are almost 45 minutes into the stream. Today we had a live stream. So we are moving on to the last section of our live stream today. Okay. So Rutvik is saying, please make some videos on technical analysis. Yeah, I will be doing videos on technical analysis as well. Don't worry on that. Slowly, steadily, we'll be making one by one. But if you want to learn, because those who are interested in technical analysis, again, the same thing. To learn a specific concept, there has to be a flow of concepts. You can't be waiting for videos so long if you are really interested in learning. Okay. So I think you can definitely go through my technical analysis lecture series. They are available. The lectures are available on my website, rachnaranade.com. And because the lockdown has been extended, I have also extended my coupon code till 30th of April. Okay, so the coupon code is Janata Curfew. And yes, that's the website, rachnaranade.com. And you will be able to avail the discount of 5%. Okay. मी एक करेक्ट आन्सर दिलेलं होतं, मला प्राईस पाहिजे, बघू ना मिळत आहे का. ओके, सो आय एम ट्राईंग टू बी व्हेरी 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 फेअर अँड ट्रान्सपरंट इन टेलिंग यू हाऊ वी हॅव कम अप विथ द फायनलाइज विथ द फायनलिस्ट ऑर विथ द विनर्स. आय कॅन से माय टीम हॅज बीन हेल्पिंग मी अ लॉट इन दिस. सो वॉट वी हॅव डन, सो फॉर एक्झाम्पल इन माय टुडेज लाईव्ह स्ट्रीम 12 PM, आय एम टेलिंग यू हाऊ वी फायनलाइज्ड our finalists, I can say. So like Jayant Doshi had given the correct answer for Kisi Ki Muskurahaton Pe, and my team has also sent me the screenshot for this. This was given at 5 minutes 5 seconds. Here you can see Jayant Doshi, Kisi Ki Muskurahaton Pe. Then we have Prahasit Devula Palli, Ye Chansa Roshan Chehra, gave at 6.29. here you can see his timestamp. So we actually checked it out video by video. My team has really worked hard on this. One by one we have done this. So there were total 28 people who gave the correct answer. Here we have a list: Jayant Doshi, Prahasit, Karan, Mitali, Nikhil, and all 28 winners are here on the screen. But as I mentioned, we are going to have only 10 out of these. So which 10 out of these Again, we have Malvika Garg who has answered twice, Karan who has answered twice, Mukul who has answered twice. So this is a website, random name picker, okay? Commentpicker.com, randompicker.com. So what we have done is we have pasted all these 28 names, which you are able to see on the screen right now. I've pasted it here, okay? So all these names, and here you can see this just randomly picks up 10 names, okay? And here you can see that those who have answered twice correctly, so like Mukul has answered twice correctly, so his name appears here twice. Or I guess there was one more name who has answered twice, Malvika. And here you'll be able to see Malvika's name also twice. See Malvika Garg and Malvika Garg. Okay, so we have just pasted it here, and now what can be done is pick a random name or winner. Okay, and I just say start. So I'm doing it right in front of you. This is completely unbiased. We are trying to find out. Okay, the first winner is Nikhil Patil. Okay, so Shubham Viraj, can I request you to write down these names? I'm also writing it down simultaneously for my reference. So the first winner is Nikhil Patil. Okay, even if there's some other person who has told twice, okay, we have also tried to be fair enough with the timestamps as well. Okay, so we reserve the right to be giving out the name of these winners, and I don't think it can be more transparent than this. Okay, pick another name. Start. Same people are now. The software is now again giving the names. Paresh Wadekar. Wow. Okay. Congratulations, Paresh. Let's pick up another name and start. Okay. Third one is Davneet Kaur. Congratulations, Davneet. Yes, now Nikhil will be removed, obviously. If we have found a winner, that winner gets removed, and now balance. See, now here you can see the amount of names is only 24 now. Okay, Prakash Viswa is the fourth one. Prakash Viswa. Congratulations, Prakash. Now you can see here, whenever I say pick another name and start, now from amount of names from 24, it will go down to 23 eventually. See, 23. Next winner is Pranav Parad. Pranav Parad. Right. I'm going again. Start with a random name picker. The next one is Vishal Thakur. Congratulations, Vishal. Going with another. I'm telling what the winners are going to get, don't worry. The winner is Abdul Hussein Abdul Latif. Abdul Hussein Abdul Latif. Good. Pick another name. Start. We have already gotten 7 winners. Now the names are 21. We are getting the next one. Prahasit Devupalli. Prahasit is the next winner. Congratulations, Prahasit. Last two names to go. Let's see who gets it. Akash Mangukia is the next name. Congratulations, Akash. And we are left with only one now. And Sagar Jabtap is the last name. Heartiest congratulations to Nikhil, Paresh, Davneet, Prakash, Pranav, Vishal, Abdul, Prahasit, Akash, and Sagar. Okay, Akash is there on the live stream. Congratulations, Akash. It's good to see that you have won. Okay, heartiest congratulations to everyone. As I said, I've tried to make this as transparent process I can. No one should feel that madam has given the gift only to those who she knows personally or something like that. Okay, Pratish says double names didn't even come once. Yeah, even I'm surprised, but you could see it on the screen. I have not done anything. Okay, so congratulations to all. What you have to do is All these seven winners, you have to write an email to and request for the prize. The email ID for you is support@rachanaranade.in. Okay, support@rachanaranade.in is the email is the email address to which you have to send your email. We will ask for a few documents from you. It could be like an Aadhaar card, so that we want to ensure that it's you only. Otherwise, anyone can say that I am XYZ person. So, for example, I am Nikhil Patil and I want to claim the prize. Nikhil Patil, you'll have to upload your other. We will tell you about which documents are to be uploaded. Then only we'll be giving you this lecture series. Okay. Good to read that you have been fair. Thank you, Chetan Chopra and future CA Sharad Pednekar. Trying to keep maximum transparency as possible, because this is what generally happens in quizzes. People feel that there is no transparency at all. We're just trying to do this at our end. Very important, those who unfortunately did not win out of the balance 28, please don't write an email stating that please consider our name. You can be lucky next time, maybe. Okay. So otherwise, see what happens. I'll tell you, people don't flood this email. I don't want emails stating that you can give us, we would love if you give us free of cost. So these people are going to get one lecture series. It could be basics of stock market or technical analysis or fundamental analysis or personal finance free of cost. What we are going to offer is basics of stock market, but we'll check in our database if any of these have already bought basics of stock market. We'll give them a choice to get access of some other lecture series as well. Okay, so this is what we had planned for those who have won. A heartiest congratulations and big round of applause from my side. Good. For those who did not get the lectures and would still want to buy it, the website is rachanaranade.com. We do have a coupon code for you as well, so you can check it out. Okay, DIL says that I bought your technical course and you are on, you have done chapter 6 also. Good. Future CA Pednekar says, hey, roz hona rahe ka, hashtag with me. If I start doing this live stream of quizzing every day at 12 p.m., then you will not be able to see me live after few days. Taking 3 live streams in a day is a big task. Just attending, just viewing it is different, but you know, coming in front of the camera, you might not be able to imagine this very basic thing, that you might be sitting in a room which has a fan, or which has an AC, which has a cooler. I do have this with me in this room, but I'm still not switching on the fan or AC or cooler for a simple reason. It will create a noise and I don't want noise in this live stream. So it has lights so that the visual is good, but I don't have any fan in this room. So it's very hot. Still, I'm doing this live stream for you all. Okay. So 3 is too much. Okay. Can't do this. Okay. I guess that's it from my side. Congratulations to all those who won this. Maybe you can think of such a quiz. Maybe once a month or something like that. Let's see how we can do this. Thank you, Chetan and Bhanu. Here are your fans. Okay, yes, thank you, thank you. That's it from many of you are saying thank you. Okay, so do follow this. I'll just check if anything is pending on my side. Okay. Okay, my team is giving a request. Team is saying that, ma'am, can we give free courses to those who answered twice correctly? Viraj and Shubham are asking this to me. Okay, done, Viraj and Shubham. Your wish is my command. I'll give free courses to those who answered twice. I mean, they were correct two times. So I will give them the free course as well. Okay, so those three people also, you can give, you can send a request to support@rachanaranade.in, right? Congratulations to all the winners and those who have. So basically all the list plus Malvika plus Mukul plus Karan. Okay, perfect. Yeah, that's it. And the person who completes the with is comment. Okay, perfect. Exactly 1 minute into 1 hour into the stream. I'm done for the day. I'll see you tomorrow, 6 a.m. live. That's it for my side for the day. Jai Hind and bye bye.